Hey guys, welcome to my channel. In today's video, I will be sharing the recipe of kharna, which is also called besan ki sabzi. The star of the recipe is the besan cubes that you see in the picture. And let's get started. So to begin with, we will prepare a besan batter for which we will add besan with garam masala, coriander powder, salt, turmeric powder, and cumin powder. We will also add chopped onions and green chili and add enough water to make batter, which is a little thick, but no lumps should be there. Now the time is to cook the batter. Just heat oil in a pan and pour over the batter and keep stirring and scraping the sides of the pan continuously to avoid any uneven cooking. And you will know the batter is ready when it is no longer sticking to the sides of the pan. So just continuously stir it and avoid any lumps also. So here you see it's nicely cooked and formed into a dough. Now's the time to spread it on a greased surface. It can be a inverted thali or any plate or any surface that you like. Let it spread and cool down. And once it cools down, just give it a shape of squares. Cut it down and let it be there. Now is the time to fry these pakoras, or you may call besan cubes or besan ki barfi, and then just fry it on a medium heat. And we want the side, the outside of it to be crispy and it should be soft on the inside. So just let it cook slowly on a medium heat. So this is how it looks like after frying. So keep it aside. It doesn't look perfect, but it goes better with practice. Okay, now is the time to prepare the gravy for this recipe. So just heat oil in a pan again and add cumin seeds and let it sputter for some time, and add some hing, asafoetida powder, and then add onions and let it turn into golden brown, and add ginger garlic paste and stir and cook to get rid of that strong smell of ginger garlic, and then add the tomatoes and let it cook for a minute, and then add salt, cumin powder, turmeric powder, coriander powder, and garam masala, and also add red chili powder. And I forgot to add green chili earlier, so adding it now, and also up 2 tablespoons of water. And stir and cook masala until oil separates, and that is the thumb rule to cook any masala. When oil separates, you know it's ready. And once the masala is cooked and you see the oil is separated on the corners, add 2 to 3 cups of water depending on how thick the gravy you're looking for or you like. Add water and cover and lower the heat. Cover and cook for approximately 5 to 7 minutes. And then add the besan squares to the gravy and cover and turn off the gas and leave it for another 5 minutes. You can garnish the gravy with coriander leaves. During quarantine, I ran out of coriander leaves, so that step is again missing. And it's ready to be served with paratha or steamed white rice. If you like this recipe, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel to get notified when I upload a new recipe again. Thank you for watching. Bye-bye.